The original idea was making the pond about 21 meters long. When I saw this, it made me reconsider, as it would be getting too close to the house. So I ended up doing 16 meters instead. The width of the swim section initially was 2.5 meters, but that came to 3 meters later on, as I saw that was a bit too narrow. Okay, so that was about the worst day. A lot of rain. Everything was already wet from a lot of rain yesterday. But everything was scheduled, so I had the shovel and I had the guy with the digger. So we made another few meters. The swimming section is about halfway now. About 2.3 meters deep from the edge with the side, and the whole thing is going to be another 6 and a bit more than that, 12.5. Meters long, 3 meters wide.
That includes the panel, so it's 320. And then putting these panels here to strengthen them, strengthen the walls from caving in, hopefully before it happens. So I'm trying to work as fast as I can, apart from doing this video. So my feet are about 2.3 meters from the surface. So that's the surface, and here will be plant filter section all around. There'll be pebbles on there. Foil first, of course.
Fortunately, the liner seems to fit quite well. I've put in some temporary supports so that I could fold back the liner on the sides, as the sand still needs to be backfilled behind the sandwich panels at the same time as the water comes in.
First water going in. Take a while. I've folded back here so I can still backfill at the same time with the water. So water will go here and then I'll backfill the sand and compress at the same time so that the pressure is equal on both sides of the sandwich panels. More or less. And then when it's all done, all the sand will be well used or removed. This extra sand I have to clean up this this side a little bit. Yeah, and then I can take my first swim. Fortunately, the bottom has no leaks. So far, so good. So at the point where the swim section is filled with water, I'm now smoothing out the filter section all around and making sure that the sand connects with the corner here of the sandwich panels, sliding right here. And then all of this will have protective fleece, like the white stuff you see here. It's also under the EPDM foil. And then I'll fold out the foil all the way across the whole thing over the sides. Then there'll be lava substrate on top of this whole filter section, which will help the plants to root and the microbial life to start helping in the filtration of the whole thing. But before that, I just forgot a step, will be placed a air filtration system. So I'm pumping air through the lava substrate using an external air pump, which will help the circulation of the water by pumping air through the substrate, and that will help the plants and everything else to get more oxygen. Then the actual substrate on top of that, and then the plants, of course. I'll finish up by doing something with the sides of the EPDM, just kind of tuck it under with some gravel or substrate on top of it, so you won't really see it so much.
I had to leave home for a few days, and when I got back, this had happened. Lots of soil washed into the water with some big rain. This was obviously a problem that needed to be addressed, and I decided to strengthen the edge and create a drainage gutter around at the same time to prevent this from happening in the future. Thank you.
eyebrows if he knows.
This is the hard work behind the paradise.
Right. Dirty job. Somebody's gotta do it. Like a nice little pebble beach here. Kind of. And erupts out. Deal with this later. Organized work, as you can see. Happens when you drive a shovel on the top.
Oh yeah, it's all ruined.
And now we have all this plastic everywhere. It's horrible.
Okay, say last word to the camera.
Don't use
a message.
Well, use something that's biodegradable, I would recommend.
After just a couple of weeks of creating the substrate and airlift filter section, the water has become extremely clear. Previously, you couldn't see maybe even a half a meter in because of the algae. This has pretty much disappeared with the microbes eating up whatever remains of the nutrients in the water. The microbes remain aerobic since they're getting fed lots of oxygen using the airlift system. The oxygenating plants will help this process later on. These are still getting planted and need to grow up. Lots of wildlife is already finding the pond, such as this 3 centimeter large water beetle. Every evening around dusk time, more and more bats are finding their way to the pond to catch mosquitoes. Seems like they're having a feast.